Hello, good day and welcome back on my channel. And for this video, I will tackle more about the Ohm's law. What is Ohm's law triangle? What is the relationship between the resistance, current, and the voltages? And what are the Ohm's law formulas and solutions? Lagi po natin naririnig kung ano ang Ohm's Law. Mapa electrical, electronics, physics, o anumang subjects, lahat may Ohm's Law. So, ano nga ba ang Ohm's Law?
Base po sa definition ng Ohm's Law, it is a relationship between voltage, current, and resistance, and how they relate to each other.
Ito naman po, ito yung Ohm's Law triangle na sinasabi ko. Nandito yung V, I, R. V is volts, I is for current, and R is for resistance. Kung nagtataka kayo kung bakit I yung current, hindi C or A for ampere,
di ba ang unit of current is ampere? And this is named after André Marie Ampère, a French physicist.
Noong unang panahon kasi, he undertook many experiments involving varying the amount of electrical current. So nung pinublish niya, tinawag niya itong intensity du current, or sa Ingles, intensity of current. So nung pinublish yung work niya in a public, kinuha nila yung letter I, na hanggang ngayon, ganito pa rin ang ginagamit as a standard.
So ano ba ang pag-interpret ng Ohm's Law triangle? So ito po yung pag-interpret ng Ohm's Law triangle. Kung kunin niyo po yung V or volts, ganito lang po. V is equal to I times R. Ganito po, simple lang. So ito po yung volts kung kukunin natin. Yung formula ng volts. Tapos naman, kung I naman or current ang kukunin, parang ganito lang po. V over R. Yun. So I is equal to V and R. Tapos yung resistance naman po is R is equal to V over I. Ganyan po kadali yung pagkuha ng formula galing dito sa Ohm's Law. So pumunta po tayo dito sa example number 1, which is ang kukunin po natin is V. Voltage yung unknown, tapos meron po tayong resistance na 100 ohms at current na 5 amperes. So base po sa kinuha natin, yung V yung kukunin po natin. So ganito, V is equal to I times R. So ito po yung formula niya. Ngayon, V which is unknown, plus I which is 5 amperes, times R, 100. So equivalent to 500 volts. Therefore, ang V po natin is 500 volts. Pumunta naman po tayo sa example number 2, which ang kinuha po natin, given yung volts, resistance 3 ohms, at kukunin po natin yung I which is a current is unknown. Sige, based dito sa Ohm's Law triangle, ganito po, I is equal to V over R. Yan. So I is equal to V which is 12 volts, tapos R, 3 ohms. So yung I po natin, 12 divided 3 equals 4. 4 amperes. So moving on to example number 3. So ito po, yung unknown po niya is resistance. So kinuha natin yung formula which nandito po is R is equal to V over I. So ito po, Yung given po niya, which is R is V, 6 volts, divided by I, which is 3 amperes. So, ang resistance po natin, 6 divided 3 equals to 2 ohms. So, alam nyo na po yung paano mag-calculate ng ohms law ng voltage, voltage amperes at resistance. Okay, moving on. Dito po sa figure na to, figure 8, so ano kaya yung na-observe niya?
So, as we can see that the resistance is same, 3 ohms. Kikita po natin yung voltage, 6 volts, 12 volts, and 24 volts. So makikita po natin na parang nagta-times 2. 6 times 2 is equal to 12. 12 times 2 is equal to 24. The same din sa current. Just 2 amperes, 4 amperes, and 8 amperes. So we can say that 2 amperes times 2 is equal to 4 amperes. 4 amperes times 2 is equal to 8. So, therefore, the voltage and the current is directly proportional to each other. When it comes to double the voltage, the current double too. Ito naman sa figure B. So, ano kaya ang inyong na-observahan about po dito sa figure na to? So, as we can observe, the voltage is same, 6 volts. Pero yung current nila is parang pababa. First one is 2 amperes, second one is 1 ampere, and third one is 0.5 ampere. Yung resistance nila is nagda-double, which is R1 is equal to 3 ohms, R2 is equal to 6 ohms, and R3 is equal to 12 ohms. In other words, the current is inversely proportional to the resistance. Or let's say, it doubled the resistance but half the current.
Can try to answer this question and write your answer in the comment box area. So what's the most deadly, voltage or current? So thank you for watching and don't forget to click subscribe to my channel for more videos. I have you now.